want to spice up the conversation a little bit more.
Yes, we've hit a bit of a plateau.
Yes, so what I was thinking...
Since we learned that that's a macabre joke...
That is not true. Now, look, I want to play a game called Word Sneak, okay?
Okay.
And here's what we're going to do. We're going to have a conversation, okay?
I know how it works. You sneak words into each other's minds using telepathy.
No, that's not at
yeah,
all. No, here's the way it's going to work. Now, you're going to read these words. You're going to try to
sneak... I understand.
You're going to try to sneak it into conversation.
Sneak it in.
Just...
Just sneak it in.
No, you don't have to do that when you say sneak
Jimmy,
it in.
Jimmy, I spend my whole life sneaking things in.
All right, look, now look. Now, Russell, you have to sneak it in.
I know what sneaking
means. To the conversation. Ready? Now, just try. Now, Russell.
I'm sneaky.
Yes, ready, go. Now, try to just go and tell the story and just try to sneak it in. Normal conversation.
Hi, Jim. It's nice to see you again.
Great to see you. You look fantastic.
Thank you. Well, that's probably because I carry out my ablutions. I exfoliate. I use a flannel. I use a loofah. I use soap all over myself. My toenails are kept super clean. I keep them polished and sparkled and covered in glitter. My physical appearance is important to me, Jimmy. I knew I was going to be visiting your macabre micro toy town. I thought, you know, keep myself well scrubbed up.
All right.
Now, I've snuck words in there.
You did sneak it in there.
Words have been snuck in.
Okay.
Do I just carry on now?
Yeah, go to the second card now. You snuck a word in. But
You've got a later on guess.
No, I'm going to sneak a word in now.
Oh, that's out of order.
No, that's the way it works.
Like, love is a two-way street.
It's like a frisbee. I throw it this way, you throw it this way.
I get it, like a frisbee.
Yes.
Is that the word?
Yes.
Oh!
No, I don't want you to guess the word. I don't want you to guess the word.
He's a genius.
I'm sneaking it into the conversation. Now, you got to sneak your second word into the conversation.
So, Jimmy, I suppose we'll be meeting Mario Batelli, who's a professional chef, is he? I suppose he makes all manner of cuisine and delightful gourmet snacks and treats, a variety of pastas and dishes and trouts and salmon and octopus, calamari, all manner of snacks from around the world, I suppose, does
he? Yes, every different type of food, from here to mythical lands.
Night what?
I don't know. I mean, I just... Hey, have you ever, seriously, though, this is...
Yeah.
What was the craziest place you've been on, like, vacation? Like, you've been, like, as a tourist, and you've seen things, and you go, like, almost like the toy town.
Like, toy town there?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because that's not a real town.
But what if, they were giant, like stones, and, like, you know, maybe the aliens brought down, or some like,
What, you think this could be an extraterrestrial monument created
Like Stonehenge. And I think that this could be like that.
You think you're dealing with Fallon? I'm from England.
Yes.
I know what a henge is.
Yes.
Stonehenge. Do I guess?
No.
Oh. You know, it's lovely that you brought the Roots with you on your journey to the top of the show business tree.
Thank you. They're the greatest in the whole land.
In the glorious cornucopia of world entertainment, you need men like them to support you, I suppose, don't you?
I do. We need great men.
Great, noble men.
Mm.
Like men like, I don't know. Hey, this game makes me feel like I'm trapped in a prism of language. I'm in a vortex of words.
I know. It's kind of fun to see you try to get out.
You've trapped me, you've tricked me, you've played games with me. I feel like I'm an instrument that you're playing. Like you're orchestrating my emotions, but with a variety of tunes, whether it's tango or mambo or, like, I don't know, some international dance festival that you're playing with my consciousness. Like, as long as I've said the word, my work is done, right?
I guess so, yeah.
A lot of these words are outrageous.
We didn't have this kind of trouble when John Goodman was here last week, I tell you that much.
Oh.
Look.
I think I've done a lot of these words, Jim, and, like, the tapes will show that I've been a bloody good sport.
Wait, so all the words that you didn't go in order, you just randomly got all the words in?
You didn't explain to me that this was, like, dictatorship of language. You didn't tell me that I was living in some sort of a sing-sing of lingo, some prison, yeah?
Yeah, well, I think you're a little nuts.
What I think you've done is you've tyrannized me with your masculinity, but there is an air of femininity to you, like you're like a perverse hybrid, like a female bodybuilder, like a person that's neither one thing or another, like a hermaphrodite with a new genital in your armpit.
No. I'm just...
I tell you what.
I'm just hard to describe. I'm like grape nuts. It's a cereal. It's wheat. It's not grapes. It's not nuts. It's a breakfast cereal, and it's good for you. And the more you eat me, the better you're gonna feel, man.
Jimmy, when you talk like that, it makes me want to kiss your bunghole.
Oh, that's it right there. Thanks to Russell Brand, everybody.